So in short, there's plenty of fundamental work and technique work and strength work that he's made strides in, but he's continued to move forward.
We're going to have a ton of receivers today, also cornerbacks too. What do you see out of those guys, particularly Waller, who had an adventuresome day, seems like it made a few good plays, got burned on.
Yeah, Jermaine, I think, has a chance. He's like kind of a microcosm of our football team right now. You know, like, he's got talent, he's young, and we don't have time to pull him aside and say, just relax, we'll call you in a couple of years when it's time to play. And but I love the way he's approached the spring. He's missed some time with a hamstring, that, you know, he still got some work, but obviously was limited. So in short, I'm excited about it. I like the way he's going about it. He's got a long way to go. And we're going to play tight coverage out there with no help. And we've got to be able to play the next play if something bad happens and if something good happens. But I like his progress so far.
Justin, your touchdown conversion in the red zone last year was right around 50%, which is far below what you were accustomed to your first year here and your last couple of years in Memphis. How much of an emphasis is that now? And on that note, was it disturbing to see a red zone turnover first possession of today?
Well, I mean, I couldn't tell. Did the ball bounce off Sean?
Yes.
Yeah, I mean, I couldn't really tell from where I was standing. I felt I knew what the look was on defense, and I knew what the play was. So, you know, that particular play bothers me that we didn't execute it. I didn't really correlate it in my mind or red zone. But, yeah, we did work on it quite a bit. I think it's going to be a key defensively. You know, I mean, we're going to be quite a bit younger defensively, too. And we may give up more yards than we have the last couple of years. We're going to have to play well in the red zone. So we got a little more work there on both sides of the ball, particularly as we got into spring, to see if we can. You know, it comes down to tight coverage. Can you make a play versus tight coverage? You know, because they put too many guys in there, and they line up pretty close to you when you're on the 8-yard line, so you have to make a play.
Obviously, Josh Jackson is number one on the depth chart at quarterback. Can we take the number of reps that Ryan Willis and Hendon Hooker got today to indicate where the other two guys are at this point in time?
I don't know that I would read anything into that. You know, I don't know what they are. If that helps you. Like, I don't know how many reps either one of them took. But we'll sit down at the end of spring and evaluate everybody's performance and move forward.
How much tougher do you think it was for Hendon last year, where he was in, I think, full-blown competition, and this year he's got Josh Jackson in front of him? How does he handle that?
Well, he's handled it really well. You know, Hendon's focused on continuing to get better. I mean, there ain't no jobs are taken. Don't play the best people. All our guys know that. So, the best guys are going to get out there and play.
Coach, quarterback's very important in every offense. In your offense, what have you seen Josh Jackson this spring and since the season ended that you've seen in terms of progress?
Well, I think he's taking another step in terms of understanding what we're trying to accomplish. He's a bright guy. Bright guy as I've coached. And he really has a high aptitude. So I think he's taking a step forward. I think there's still room for him to be pushed. He still needs to fall more in love with the process.
Okay.
I think he needs to fall more in love with preparing. You know, I think he does a good job of that, but I think there's another level of detail that he can reach in his preparation. But I've been really pleased with him. Okay. Just between the two of us.
Obviously, we came and talked a lot about the linebacker position and the youth there. What have you seen from Rivers and Ashby and how they've developed?
Well, I think we've got a lot of work to do there. Rayshard seems to have a pretty good understanding of what's going on. He's a really heavy ball player. Not that the other guys aren't, but you know, we're going to continue to, we're going to have to continue to evaluate and coach and teach and develop there with Dylan and Rayshard and the rest of the crew. I mean, no matter who it is, it's going to be young. You know, we're going to get ready to play.
You told us Thursday that, you know, Adonis had a school issue. Is there any concern about whether you'll have him in the fall, or are you certain?
I'm not going to get into other guys' school stuff. Like, I got concerned every day about all our guys, so we'll figure that out. Everything comes out.
Thanks, Coach.
Yep.
Questions for Josh?
They've grown up a lot. Had a lot of injuries in their receiving core. Transferring, that's going to be an awesome player for us. I mean, they've made great strides, but still got something to go. Whole team, still got to get better, get ready for first.
I think you have the two touchdown throws.
Yeah.
Can you walk us through what you saw on those, or are they already in distant memory?
Not in distant memory yet. I mean, they're just RPO, kind of matched the running back, and I got a good look on the outside, I take it, and had a good look, made a ball play.
Did you know early that was going to be a big play, or when do you know that that's got a chance?
Yeah, I just took a peek over there, and I know. We've been repping all spring, and it just worked out.
I know this is a game, but it's been a while since you played the game. How do you stay out there and have this moment again?
Yeah, definitely. It's good to get in front of the Hogue fans again. Playing last spring, didn't do much because I was ineligible. But, I mean, it feels good to be back on the field, out there with my friends, just playing ball and having fun.
Yeah, you mentioned before, did you miss playing? I mean, I think last time we talked to you, you sort of fell in love with football.
Yeah, I mean, it hurt not playing. It really hurt not playing, especially playing the first 2 years and having the red shirt sit out due to NCAA rules. But, I mean, I'm just happy to be out there with my friends again, playing the game I love.
Back
here. Hey, Ryan. Let's talk about working with Josh all spring. What did you learn from him? You know, every night you were here last year, but what did you learn from him this year with him? You know, what's he teaching you to become a better quarterback?
I don't know if it's as much teaching, but we kind of push each other, battling. We want to be the best we can be. Push each other intellectually. Push each other physically. Just competitive people, want to be the best, and whatever numbers call, we're both going to be there.
What's that quarterback look like? You've got Josh, who played last year, Hendon, who set up.
Oh, yeah, definitely. On offense, we definitely came out a little flat today. But Coach Dustin, the locker room, had time that we needed to pick it up, that we needed a spark, basically.
Hey, Deshaun, talk about that run you did around the third quarter, the late third, early fourth, and you just took off and you just went out to the left, you know, like outside. Just talk about that.
Well, the play was designed for me to, like, kind of get it and pick the outside zone and cut it up. And once I cut it up, it was pretty much the block was there, so I just hit it and scored.
How was the spring game? Do you guys go to halftime on this offense? Like, we had 0 points. Like, does that bother you in a spring game a lot?
Definitely, because we have a lot of competitors on offense and on defense. So, like, every day we go out there and compete. So that's all it is. We're definitely competitors, and we don't like to lose on offense.
Talk about your first night in Washington. What do you?
I remember seeing your tape in high school and how you kind of went between an outside linebacker and a defensive end. Can you talk about the past couple of springs, getting back kind of into that defensive end mold from standing up, playing on the outside?
Well, transition between linebacker and defensive end, it wasn't too bad, I would say, just basically because, you know, in high school, I played linebacker my first 3 years, and then it wasn't until my senior year. I put my hands in there with, like, the last 7 games. But I felt like it was a good transition just based off first game at defensive end in high school. I had 3 sacks, so it was kind of good for me, so made a good transition.
You were in a competition, obviously, for looks like second team, which is obviously going to be a step up for you considering you're still learning the position a little bit. Do you feel like
like you did some things this spring to sort of put yourself on the map a little bit, and how hard is it in a setting like today where you kind of show exactly what
I feel like, you know, my senior year at defensive end, I learned to play faster, learned to scheme a little bit better, but, you know, two-hand touch, football is what it is, you know, you just got to go out there and compete. And I feel like I competed, you know, got out of the quarterback a little bit, missed a few I could have got, but, you know, just got to work on that, so keep working.
Two-hand touch.
Really improved and can help us. I mean, he's been a guy that
guy that is extremely heady, extremely cerebral, can put the offense in a good play against a certain look, or maybe weeks down. And there were some times this spring we played some cat and mouse, and obviously he's getting some calls from the offense, but he knows what he should be checking to and things of that nature. Just a guy that's extremely heady, you know, playing the way he did and having the experience he has, yeah, without a doubt, that's a big, big plus for us. And, you know, he knows how to attack us. If we play against these guys for, well, now for, this is the third spring, and then we do stuff early in the morning, so they've seen us, and they know our signals, and they know everything about us, you know what I mean? So it's, we've been trying to trick them ourselves, but we can't do that. But, no, I think, I really do think he is taking his game to another level this spring, and what you would think with a guy that, you know, is a quarterback last year. Thank you, buddy.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you, baby.
Thank you.
Soon we were taking it serious, me and you underneath a mysterious spell. Nothing I could do, and it suddenly felt like a bolt out of hell. I'm telling you, to the sound of the beat I was hanging on, like a powerful truth it was banging on me. Wouldn't let me go, like a shot in the dark. She was hot like a spark. I only know neither one of us trying to hold it down, neither one of us taking the middle ground. Wasn't how to make sense we were thinking of, just the two of us bent on delirious love. Me and you being spent on delirious love.
Meant to cut me down, and if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by